And good afternoon, everybody. Logan here from Jack 1021. It is day three of the Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival, Medicine Hat's Winter Folk Music Festival. We've got another great afternoon of music in store for you. If you want to support the Medicine Hat Folk Music Club and the artists you see here all this week, you can do so at paywhatyoucan.mhfolkmusic.com. Our first artist for this afternoon, he has been a sideman for a lot of great artists. Now he's got his own solo album coming up. Kicking off day three of the Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival, please welcome Greg Carroll.
Thank you very much. I'm very happy to be here. The last time I was here was indeed as a sound man. I was playing here with Amos Garrett. I was playing string bass. And I had a lot of fun then. And here I am now, all by my lonesome. So anyway, to let you guys know why I'm here, is that when I was down in Nashville in 2019, I was doing some gigs down there writing, and a music video for Black Mountain Whiskey Rebellion. It's one of the bands that I play in. And of course, there's lots of history, war memorials everywhere there. And I start thinking, I wonder if there's any First Nations that fought in these wars. And I start doing some research, and I went down the rabbit hole. And indeed, they did. So I'm First Nation. I'm proud Mi'kmaq from Newfoundland, St. George's, Newfoundland, I'm originally from, now living in High River, Alberta. So I wrote an album of songs about First Nations that fought in wars and pivotal battles and also inter-tribal wars as well. So I'm going to start off with this guy, this young gentleman from the Maritimes. He decided to go to Vietnam and fight with his brothers from the south, but he never came back. The song is called Never Coming Back from Vietnam.
Crossed in the U.S. port from Canada up north, a small reserve north of Bangor, Maine. Joined my brothers from the south to infiltrate and rout. Fighting's what we do from going insane. There are times in your life and you take on all the strife, and I'm never coming back from Vietnam. I make my wife's at home, my child's all alone. Got a woman in Saigon just out of fear. From the forest to the mire, the mangrove swamp is dire. I enroll in this hell, don't you shed a tear. There are times, can't you see, that I got to be me, and I'm never coming back from Vietnam. Take another tour, and I'm never coming back from Vietnam. And there's one thing's for sure, I can't take another tour, and I'm never coming back from Vietnam. No, I'm never coming back from Vietnam.
Thank you very much. That is the title track off my record, Point of No Return. That'll be released once I get some money to Canada Council, once they give money to Indians who look white. I said, look white. And I can say that. All right. Some really good choreography going on here now. Change guitars. I'm that guy, right? Changing guitars on the second song already. Well, this next song is Americana. I decided to write about the Comanche tribe once I went down the that rabbit hole. And I found out that in the panhandle of Texas, Petit Chief of Comanche tribe, which is mentioned as your song, and his son Quan Parker was a, for all intents and purposes, a half-breed. So he was the last chief of Comanche tribes. He was half white. Imagine that. This was a very dark time because the U.S. Army were hunting down indigenous people and throwing them in jails. And Quan Parker, he was the last to surrender, him and a ragtag team of Braves. After they starved him out in September, in June, they finally capitulated, went to Fort Sill and surrendered. This song is called Palo Duro Canyon. Petit Chief of Comanche tribe took for Parker and a young white bride. Kawana Parker was born in a time to be torn by the Red River War. Colonel Mackenzie was his name, called him Bad Hand just the same. Buffalo soldiers at hand, tracking down Indian men. Kawana Chief of Comanche tribes. Can you feel the thunder now? Can you hear the four-wind howl? Can you see Bad Hand coming? Your squaws and young scared to run it in Palo Duro Canyon. September 1874. Supply camp was to be no more. Surrounded by Bad Hand and his men, Lone Wolf had no time to defend Empire Palo Duro Canyon. Can you feel the thunder now? Can you hear the four-wind howl? Can you see Bad Hand coming? Your squaws and young scared running in Palo Duro Canyon. Last chief of Comanche tribes, with the June sun in their eyes, surrendered in Fort Sill. The army took their damn will in the Red River War. Can you feel the thunder now? Can you hear the four-wind howl? Can you see Bad Hand coming? Your squaws and young scared running in Palo Duro Canyon. In Palo Duro Canyon. Thank you very much. I guess I had to go into Canadiana now strictly to guilt. After I have a drink of water. This is way different than holding my bass, standing next to the drummer, watching the lead singer talk to the audience. Or the camera. Aw, my aunt. Aunt Bernie. Love you too, Aunt Bernie. From California. Victorville, California, actually. The high desert. What guitar am I taking? Oh, this one here. All right, what am I doing next? So I wrote a song about this Indigenous war hero named Tommy George, and he was a bad ass. So he'd go behind enemy lines and cut the throats of German soldiers. And that obviously messed with their minds quite a bit. So he was ruthless and very important as well, because that's war, right? If you leave the reserve after 4 years, you can't come back. And he had to keep going. He was like a professional soldier kind of deal. So after World War II, he had to sign up for Korea because he had no home to go back to. And unfortunately, he didn't have a wife or kids or nothing like that either. So he died alone in an old age home. And I think more people should know who Tommy George is and how important he was in the Second World War. So here's a song for Tommy George. Volunteer parachute battalion in the war, U.S. Special Force. Devil's Brigade is what the Germans call you then. Raised in hell in a land that never sinned. I killed you bastards in your sleep. You never saw the light. Your soul's gone straight to hell on that autumn night. You can run and you can hide. Tommy George will make your family cry. Bravery, he got American Silver Star. Had no home to go back to, been gone away too long. Been gone away too long. Been gone away too long. Signed up for Korea's war, had no choice to see. Never saw a yellow man until the knife went deep. Until the knife went deep. Until the knife went deep. You can run and you can hide. Tommy George will make your family cry. Battle for your country with less than no support. Honorable discharge now. Now I'm nothing worth. And now I'm nothing worth. And now I'm nothing worth. A broken down soldier with no health or wife. Prejudice just follow me until the end of life. Until the end of life. Until the end of life. He didn't run and he didn't hide. Tommy George had no family to cry.
didn't run and he didn't hide. Tommy George had no family to
very much. Tommy George. All the pictures that I saw of him, he always had a big smile on his face. I'm going to keep going, Canadiana, just because I think I got more applause than I did for the Palo Duro Canyon. So I'm going to do that just to just the studio audience here. I'm gonna keep them all appeased here. No, it's actually on my set list. I do have a set list right here. See this? So I'm actually cheating. Oh, there's the red lights on right there. So there you go. So next one is called Timberwolf Battalion. And this is in standard and capo one. So I gotta put this thing on the first fret. See, you're getting a music lesson too, you know? So this next song, I decided to write about World War I. And I'm like, okay, what happened in World War I? First Nations. And I found this, the Timberwolf Battalion out of Manitoba. And Captain Glenn Campbell, he married an Ojibwe lady, and they recruited some Indigenous sons to go fight the Western Front. Battle of the Ridge, they took Hill 70. It was the 107th Battalion, and they were very, very important. And once again, nobody knows about that, and they should, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm here. I should hope so, anyway. Anyway. So this song here, I think, was like the fourth song that I wrote, and it's kind of got like a little bit of a lullaby thing to it, so I'm gonna put you guys to sleep, but no. When I wrote this song, I was like, when I came up with the guitar riff, I was like, oh, that sounds kind of cool. Hope I don't screw it up now. Timberwolf Battalion.
Evening, fighting across Sea War One. Captain Glenn, his wife Ojibwe, recruited some Indigenous sons. Battle of the Western Front. Men follow where they stand. 107th Battalion calling into battle with Indigenous man. Dakota, make my Creole Ojibwe Blackfoot too from the schools. 1,000 men set sail for England from Halifax to Liverpool. Side by side, spring of 1917, Hill 70 fell with native pride. coming home with no reception. A thousand nightmares no one can see. I fight while they lost our people. Indigenous man, admit defeat. You won our war, now admit defeat.
Thank you so much. What we got here next? Oh, yeah. How all this here started. As I talked at the very beginning of the show, I was in Nashville, and it was the Civil War that piqued my interest, and I did my research, and I discovered the Treaty of Watertown. So, Indigenous people always sided with the rebels because the Union and North, they broke every treaty with Indigenous people. So they didn't trust the North, but they trusted the South. But when the South went down, they kind of went and had no choice, right? They were done. But the First Nations, Indigenous people, they felt slighted, they felt abandoned, because, you know, they fought and they thought they were going to win this war too, and then, you know, all of a sudden they didn't win it. And I should also preface by saying that I wrote a song with my good friend Eric Dillon, who's a Southerner, so I'm like, why not write a song about the South of the Southerner, right? So there's two co-writes on this, on my record, and here's one of them. And we wrote this in Nashville. In January, February 2020, actually. So this is called The Treaty of Watertown. Cold this time of year, prove the hunger ain't got no fear. People of the dawn, 10,000 strong, ain't got much to hold, but we still hold on. Watertown, Watertown, we fought the war and then you sold us out. Watertown, Watertown, Watertown. Running from the steel, they're fast and main. Taking our men in the land of the queen. Rebels and tribes and something left to lose. You never told us that you wanted it to. Watertown, Watertown, we fought the war and then you sold us out. Watertown, Watertown, Watertown. We fought by your side, gave you our own lies. We thought that you believed in freedom. Well, we might as well just slit our wrists and damn you Yankee hypocrites, cause either way, we end up cold and bleeding. Here in Watertown, Watertown, we fought the war and then you sold us out. Watertown, Water.
Watertown, Watertown. Johnny Rib, lies fly from your mouth. You send us straight to hell when we fought for the South. You never would have won without a few good risking men. So you couldn't fight with puns, so you use us Indians. Here in Watertown, Watertown, we fought the war and then you sold us out. Watertown, 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 down in Watertown.
Thank you. I'm going to pick my lungs up after that one. As I started playing, I went, oh, I forgot to switch guitars on this one. That one's down a half step, so it's easier for me to sing, but oh, well. It was good exercise, you know? All right, well, for my next trick. I wrote a song about my tribe is Mi'kmaq. From the eastern seaboard of the United States and the Maritimes and Newfoundland. And we had a ongoing feud, unfortunately, we were actually mortal enemies with the Mohawk. And the reason for that is that both the Mi'kmaq and the Mohawk were fighting side by side with the Confederates, and then the British made a deal with the Mohawk. And then the Mohawk decided to side with the North, and that didn't bode very well at all with the Mi'kmaq. So they had bloody battles. I'm happy to say there's a truce now between the two tribes, which is a good thing. When the Oka crisis happened, the Mi'kmaq were there going, hey guys, if you need us, we're there for you, because how it works now where we have a truce, whenever we have a powwow, our flag is flown the same height as the Mohawks, and vice versa. That's the respect we have for each other's tribes now. So when the crap hit the fan at Oka, our militia was going, hey, you want us to come and take care of some stuff? It's a good thing they didn't, because history would have been very, very different today. But anyway, I'm going to talk about when they were enemies. Oh, there's my mom, listener from Newfoundland. There you go. My mom, Lily and Carroll. So in Cape Breton, there's this mountain called Fitzpatrick Mountain. And what our tribe did, we got chased from the border of Quebec, New Brunswick, all the way back. Well, we actually retreated, but what we were doing was do a strategy because we knew the mountain. So the Mohawk chased us all the way back, and they ran up the mountain. And we were there waiting for them when they came down. So anyway. This song here is called The Battle of Fitzpatrick Mountain. I'm going to make sure I'm going to sing this in the right key for you, too. All right, here we go.
Arrowhead, brazen man, chief of Mi'kmaq tribe. Foes coming from the west, no fear to kill or die. The Mohawk is our enemy, older than Confederacy. We kill the one, we kill them all on Fitzpatrick Mountain. Chief Grey Wolf retreated up the mountainside. Mi'kmaq knew when you're way up there ain't no place left to hide. Turning rivers into red, flowing like a fountain. Count your blessings, count your dead on Fitzpatrick Mountain. We didn't kill for self-righteousness. We killed because we had to. Now we look up there and see something darker than the mountain shadow. In the end, you paint your face and take a side. Everybody wants to hold their ground, but nobody wants to die. Maybe if you just left our tribe alone, we wouldn't have to tell your wife where to find their bones. They cast a gray wolf later that day with bows and tomahawks. Found the highest place he could and tossed him on their rocks. How he survived that fall from hell, it was only vengeful will. Captured forever, he could hear the cry on Fitzpatrick Mountain, on Fitzpatrick Mountain, on Fitzpatrick Mountain. On Fitzpatrick Mountain.
Thank you very much. Cheers from Tippy's Tavern, Kingston. Yeah, I like Kingston. Played here before. Well, speaking of tavern, I got about three more songs till I hit one. So now we're going to go into my, I'm writing another record now. As I'm waiting to release the first one. So I wait on grant money. Right, Mr. Rob Pape? Host with the most of my grant writer. So until then, I'm just going to keep writing. So on Remembrance Day, I was actually sitting in my garage, which is kind of like my studio, and I was just going through the news feeds, and all of a sudden, it was this article about Peggy, this guy named Peggy. And I went, Peggy? I went, huh. Hello, Mike from Texas. And he was like a Tommy George, the same thing, but he was a sniper. So he killed, like, almost 400 people. Like, that's, you know, he was fearless. Fearless and deadly. He was very important, too. And I'm talking about the World War I here is what I'm referring to here, of course. So he was from Parry Sound, Ontario, Ojibwe. So I decided to write a song about him. And I did, and here it is. Hope you guys like it. I hope my mom does.
Am I being in the right key here? Yeah, okay, here we go. Capo 2. Too many capos.
Show business, I gotta tune down first.
Tune down, put on the capo.
All right, Peggy.
I died with my boots on, couldn't afford new shoes. Sniper in the Great War died in 52. Peggy is my name, Ojibwe from the Sound. Killed by 400 men, I know what death's about. Made love nowhere, far from Paris Sound. Surrounded by fear, load my gun and watch those soldiers fall like their loved ones' tears. Loved ones' tears. Running as a goose behind the lines and wind.
took 300 soldiers and 3 medals for the win. There's a statue in my town to remind of yesterday. Hope that young folks know who what I am today. I'm in the middle of nowhere, far from Paris Sound, surrounded by fear, load my gun and watch those soldiers fall like your loved ones' tears. Your loved ones' tears. I'm begging back a mo-o-g away from the sound. I kill 400 men, I know what that's about. Thank you so much. Oh, my cousin's husband just said they're watching from Muddy Hole. That's actually a town. Well, not a town, it's a hamlet in Newfoundland. There you go. Oh, my cousin, Len. All my family's chiming in, eh? Strictly out of pity. Yeah, I got a song. I wrote this song. I was sitting in my garage once again, and of course we have Chinook winds down here, right? Being from Southern Alberta, living in Southern Alberta, and we get used to it, of course. But there was this one night. It was really, really howling. It was like I thought the roof was gonna come right off my garage, and so I started writing a song about that, and I wrote 2 verses. And then I looked at it the next day, because I usually walk away from what I write, and then it's like, okay, what did I do last night? And I went, what am I writing a song about the weather for, you know? And so I'm like, okay, there had to be some battles in Southern Alberta between the Cree and Blackfoot. And yes, there was, the Battle of Belly River. So I did my research, and then the first verse and the last verse of the song, the first 2 verses, what I wrote of my nature song, my weather song, the first verse ended up being the first verse, and the second verse ended up being the last verse. And in between, I, did a history thing. You know, that's what I do. So, the Battle of Belly River, the Cree weren't as patient as the Blackfoot, because they scouted. They were scouting one night, and they came up on a blood camp, and instead of going back to the Cree, saying, hey, we found a blood camp, they attacked. Then the pagans who lived west of them on Old Man River didn't like that. So they attacked them in the morning. And then Blackfoot found out about it and jumped all over them again. So the poor Cree, they lost over 400 men, and it was bloody. Anyway. So I wrote a song about it. And here we go. I thought it'd be appropriate as we're sitting here in Medicine Hat. And Lethbridge is just down the road. Belly River is what's known as Old Man River today. Southern winds creep at my door, beat at the windows, rattle my floors. Lights flicker, dark to almost dim, those lonesome badlands howl the wind. Back in the fall of 1870, Battle of the Cree and Blackfoot Confederacy.
fighting for the Cypress Hills. Blackfoot is blinded by Cree's vengeful will. Big Bear, Little Pine Scout that night found a blood camp long before light. Till their Cree no attack, instead the pagans entered their war for their dead. The Battle of Belly River, the southern wind soul shivers. The ghosts of 400 Cree crying echoes the banks of the old man wine. Crowfoot chief made peace and Poundmaker leader of the Cree. Things became as they are after the Battle of Belly River. Of Belly River. Of Belly River. Sun broke a gray red sky, now Cree had only hell to deny. Blackfoot and blood on their heads, now time counts the wounded and their dead. Below the hills, the valley sings, time moves on, change as the seasons bring. Whatever's lost and never found, the lonesome cry of yesterday's winds howl.
Thank you. And now for my last song. I got to give credit to Mr. Rob Pape for this, because he sent me a movie and said, I think you probably write a cool song out of this. And I've never watched the movie before and wrote a song. I've read books, I've read articles, newspaper articles, different articles, whatever, but I've never, and I mean never, watched a movie and written a song, and I'll never do that again. An hour and a half movie took me like 4 hours to watch. So, taking notes and all that stuff with the subtitles on. So the movie that I'm referring to is Monfort T. Johnson. Hi, Tom Keeler from High River, one of my students. Once again, he's just doing it strictly out of guilt. Or probably looking for a free lesson. I kid. So Monfort T. Johnson, the Johnson Ranch down in Oklahoma, they're a big-time ranching family now. Monfort T. Johnson, he's Chickasaw. And this was during the time where the South surrendered, and then the Army decided that they're going to jail Indians. So here's a song about that story in time. Drink of water here. This is how I drink water. All right, this song is called A Trail of Tears.
Jackson trading land for Indian fear. Chickasaw tribe from the southeast woodlands, wandering Oklahoma, Indian territory in bands. Mm-hmm. Montford T. Johnson, his Chickasaw mother's spirit sent on that night to join her ancestors. English wife, father fled east from the west, leaving two children with her child was the best. Sergeant Richter, thirsty for rebel blood and scalp. Cattle rust is pillaging and torching as hired help. Grant's Union Army is starving the haggard South. Killing the buffalo food for Indigenous mouths. Cheyenne, Kiowa, Camp Lodge, Bull River, Running Wolf and his men hunting winter shiver. Heard the terror screams of their women and children. Custer's deadly ambush, now they can only listen. Montford heard of runaway circumstance. Friends, they've been a long time before Johnson's ranch. Rider Ford sealed to free his Cheyenne friend. 67 and 78, the army jailed the Indian. Sergeant Richter, thirsty for rebel blood and scalp. Cattle rushes pillaging and torching as hired help. Grant's Union Army starving the haggard South. Killing the buffalo food for Indigenous mouths.
Thank you so much. I hope I pass the audition. I'm Greg Carroll, everyone. Thank you guys so much for listening to my songs. Well, hello, Jeremy. How are you?
I'm good. That's Greg Carroll, part of day three of the Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival at Medalta Potteries here in Medicine Hat. That was a great set. Thank you so much for doing that.
Thank you very much for having me.
You've been at this festival before, you said, working sound?
No.
No? Did I mishear that? Or?
You did.
Oh, I am so sorry.
You shouldn't wake and bake, dude.
I'm sorry. Anyways, what is it like to be a part of this festival, regardless in what capacity you're doing?
I was here with Amos Garrett, actually.
I'm so sorry.
I kid. It's all good, man. I kid. Yes, I was here with Amos Garrett playing upright bass the last time I was here, and I really enjoyed the vibe. And since then, like I said, Rob took it over. So it's even better now. There you go.
It's so bigger and better every single year. We're happy to have you this year.
Right on.
You've got a solo album on the way, Point of No Return. You played songs off of that. You're telling stories of Indigenous history, their involvement in battles of yesteryear. How important do you think it is to really tell these stories? You mentioned that, you know, not a lot of people know about them. How important is it to get these stories out there?
I think it's very important because it's part of our history. It's part of Canadian history. It's part of American history. And the fact that not a lot of people know, like, you know, Tommy George. Who's Tommy George? Right, mm-hmm. Kind of deal. And more people should know what he did and what other Indigenous soldiers did, kind of deal, what they accomplished, what I mean, in all these wars. I just found it quite intriguing reading the stories, but I also was disappointed in knowing that this wasn't common knowledge. Like, we weren't even taught this in schools.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it really should be put into curriculum, in my opinion. So.
Throughout the set, you mentioned you did your research. When you're researching these stories and these people, how do you determine what or who can really make a good song for you?
Wow, it takes a lot of reading. There's a lot of research, stuff like that. First of all, it's got to kind of catch my eye, you know, catch my ear, or, you know what I mean? Where mm-hmm. it's like, that just could sound like a good song, or it could be a good song kind of deal. And it's all about, you know, the topic or, you know, and for myself, it's like, I just found it fascinating to find out that, you know, my tribe, the Mi'kmaq, like, we fought in Vietnam, and I didn't know about that, right? I'm like, mm-hmm. what, are you kidding me? You know, because there's no borders with Indians, right? You know, that's the thing. Like, you know, the Mi'kmaq tribe, we stretched down into Maine. Like, actually, we are from Maine. We're an American band, actually. But then, you know, there was no border, so we stretched out into New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, PEI, and Newfoundland.
And you said you really first had this idea for this album, Point of No Return, back in 2019.
Yes.
You've done all your research. Are you just a big history buff in general?
Yes, I am. I love history. I watch the History Channel. I read history books. I love biographies pertaining to history and stuff like that. Yes, I really do enjoy history, especially Indigenous history. And especially history that nobody, you know, like, few people know about, like, not nobody, but few people know about, mm-hmm. more people should know about.
So I guess it comes to a point of, how do you think, what's the best way to get these stories out there? You mentioned part of a curriculum. Maybe your album can be kind of an educational tool, do you think?
I would like to think so. I'd like to hope so. Like, that's really... I want to bring awareness, you know, during a time when awareness is being brought forth. My awareness is a little bit different, where it's like, hey, did you guys know that, you know, these brave soldiers, Indigenous soldiers, fought in your wars, you know what I mean, kind of deal, and died doing it? And, you know, and even if they won the war, they came home to nothing. Like, there was no house, they were poor. They you know, and they went and they died for their country, like, you know, specifically Canada. And was treated like a second-class citizen when they came home, you know, similar to the Vietnam vets when they came back from Vietnam, right? And, you know, kind of deal. So, and it was pure racism and prejudice while you were treated like crap. It was like, you know, oh, well, you know, you're an Indian, so you should be over there fighting wars. Well, you know, what better are you here, you know, doing here, right? So, that's how I kind of look at that. And like I said, and being a big history buff, when I went down that rabbit hole, this record came out pretty quick. I must say, like, the writing of it, I start writing it in late November, and I was finished writing in early February.
Kind of. Wow.
So it came out fairly quickly. But I also knew, like I said, once I went down that rabbit hole, like, I knew what I was getting myself into, so to speak, right? So, and I'm still doing it. Like, I'm still researching. Mm-hmm. You know? And if anybody's got any stories that they'd love to send to me, please do, you know, and I'll write a song about it, you know? You know, you got my website there, www.gwcarroll.ca. So if there's any stories of First Nations that anybody has, you know, please bring them forth, and I'll see what I can do. But, you know, I love writing songs. I love songs about Indigenous history.
Pass them along. All right. And again, Greg Carroll, thank you so much for being here, part of the Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival here in Medicine Hat. It's great to have you back, and I'm sure you're welcome back anytime.
Awesome.
Thank you. I haven't talked to Rob, but I'm unofficially extending an invitation on his behalf to come back anytime.
He'll get me back strictly out of guilt, I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm sure. It's day three of the Medicine Hat Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival. Again, you can support the Medicine Hat Folk Music Club and the artists you've been seeing all week with paywhatyoucan.mhfolkmusic.com. And with that, we will send it back inside the kiln for a band based out of Calgary. They've got a full-length album out later this year as well. We're so happy to have the Red Hot Hayseeds. Take it away.
She's a part of the river as she follows the stream. When she moans in the middle of night, makes me say that someday I might lay down my heavy load and get on board and sing the song of the steamboat all day. Billows on the sandy shore, sleep and dream all day. But when that steamboat rounds,
so much, folks. We are the Red Hot Hayseeds from Calgary, Alberta.
On this Western Swing Wednesday.
I'm very happy to be here. I was here this time last year doing a solo set right in this very kiln, but happy to be back with the band here. That was a Merle Travis song, a lesser-known Merle Travis tune. We like to play a mix of old-timey hits of the yesteryear and some deep cuts mixed in with our own originals. This is an old song, an old Cindy Walker song.
It's called Don't Count Your Chickens Before They Hatch.
Also a fun, happy song. One, two, one, two.
Chickens before they hatch. If you got the mind, you're gonna two-time me. Baby, you've met your match. If you think you can two-time me one more time, don't count your chickens before they hatch. Love, but I'm not gonna bag it. Let's get down to scratch. Well, just because you think I'm a good old hen, don't count your chickens before they hatch.
down to scratch. Well, just because you think I'm a good old egg, don't count your chickens before they hatch. Don't count your chickens before they hatch.
Thanks so much, folks. Tune we're gonna do is a song of ours. This is a song I wrote as my own personal theme song for the Calgary Stampede. We collectively play quite a few gigs during the Stampede, as we like to call it Cowboy Halloween.
If you couldn't tell by our outfits.
It's my own disclaimer. I'm not a cowboy, I just play one on TV. The song's called I Know Cowpoke. You can find it wherever you digest music.
Ooh, he ain't no cowboy.
Well, I ain't no cowpoke, I never open ride. No leather pistol holster, no chaps upon my thighs. I ain't no cowpoke, you probably could guess. I ain't no cowpoke, I just like the hats.
Cowpoke, he just likes the hats.
Oh. I ain't no cowpoke, I've never milked a cow. Take me to your pappy's ranch, you can show me how. I rode down the highway, they rolled in the dirt. I ain't no cowpoke, I just like the shirts. Six string, a Chevy is my horse. Playing every podunk town, east, south, west, and north. Setting up and tearing down, setting up again. I'm a slinger of the six string, picking where I can. Chaps upon my thighs. I ain't no cowpoke, I still roll in the hay. I ain't no cowpoke, and I like it that way.
Thank you very much. We're going to pass the helm over to Miss Sydney Zadravec over here. I'm going to take a Red Hot minute, actually, to introduce the Red Hot band. Here at Red Hot Hayseeds Incorporated, we've got Mr. Keith Roger on the end, on the upright bass here. Such a good boy. We have Miss Sydney Zadravec here on the fringe jacket. We have Miss Dayna Lyn on the skirt and the hat. Me on Tyler. Yeah, whatever. Thank you. Anyway, take it away, Sid. Just as soon as I'm ready.
You guys are all killing it. Did you get my joke? I said, y'all are killing it.
Thank you. is singing his lonesome cattle call.
Everybody.
Thank you so much, folks. Forgot I sat down. Again, we are the Red Hot Hayseeds from Calgary, Alberta. We're gonna go out to an island, the island of New Zealand, where our dear friend Tammy Nielsen lives. She wrote this next song called Texas.
Texas is not an island.
Got a touch that lingers on my fingers. I've got a kiss for lips so sweet and won't you let me squeeze you tight? I've got a touch that lingers on my fingers. I've got a kiss for lips so sweet and true.
just love just switching instruments. It's my favorite thing. Give it up for Greg Carroll, everybody. Great songs. Great songs. And thank you to everybody here at Tongue on the Post Fest, Medicine Hat Folk Club. And shout out to Rob Pape. Sorry you couldn't be here, buddy, but thanks for having us out here. At least your wife's here. She's super cool, so.
Yeah. Oh, wait, you're up.
Oh, Keith, did you write this song? I do believe our bass player, Keith, wrote this next little number.
Just having a time over here.
I do really like seeing the comments come up, and thank you so much, Margaret, for your sweet comments, but I find I'm watching the TV too much, and there's a slight delay between what we do and what's on the TV, so I have to maybe not stare at the screen so much. Well, what's this song, Keith?
This is the Cowboy Boot Waltz.
Wow.
Written about cowboy boots.
All right.
Away from me.
This place bought my blues a brand new pair of shoes, and I'm taking them out on the town. They walk slow and low, and they keep out the snow, but goddamn if I won't wear them out. Oh, they're looking cracked and they're needing some patching, but what have they done for me? Except hurting my feet, dragging me out to meet the kind of trouble I really don't need. Step all the time, now I just sashay straight to the bar. I'm drunk, broken, hopeless, I shouldn't have smoked this. And babe, could I go sleep in your car? I'm singing, please, please, Lordy, please, while you're saving my soul, save the soles of my feet. Please, please, Lordy, please get these boots away from me, off of me. Please, please, Lordy, please, while you're saving my soul, save the soles of my feet. Please, please, Lordy, please get these boots away.
Keith Roger, everybody. Two of his.
I got a pick jar of a microphone stand. Is this so hard to open?
I need to wet my whistle. Well, I hope you're all having a good a start of the year as you can out there in TV land. This next one is a song that will be on our upcoming record. The song is called I Don't Want a Secondhand Romance. This is an old song from a long time back called... Oh, nice, Sid. It's your mom. The song is called I Don't Want a Secondhand Romance.
Secondhand romance, some discarded love that isn't new. I don't want to.
and heart, and after a while have mine torn apart. I don't want to take another's place and try to share a love that won't be true. I don't want a secondhand romance, but darling, I'll take a chance on this romance with you. I don't want a secondhand romance, some discarded love that isn't new. I don't want to hold a secondhand heart, and after a while have mine torn apart. I don't want to take another's place share a love that won't be true. I don't want a secondhand romance, but darling, I'll take a chance on this romance with you.
This next song is a tune of mine. It's a song I wrote a very long time ago that I've sort of reprised for this band. This song is called The Heartache Gospel. All right.
Been lost if we wound up here so unfamiliar, but we're right at home. You know, wherever we go, we'll find the ramblers, bones and stragglers with their hearts aglow. And it's one more night of the heartache gospel, whiskey Pentecostal variety show. Thank you. must have been stoned. Long, red-eyed and hopeful to think we'd ever get back on chasing a song. And though we'll never grow up quite the way we were told to, I'm doing just fine scraping along. It's one more night, the heartache gospel, the whiskey Pentecostal variety show.
You who have never been in a kiln, it's pretty warm, a bit dry. I understand why it cures pottery. Makes so much sense now.
Yeah.
If you're wondering at home.
This is a, as you might expect, this is another old song from a long time back. Bit of a deep cut, this one. Song is by a woman named Bonnie Guitar. If you've never checked out Bonnie Guitar, I highly recommend.
Oh.
Hope we didn't put you to sleep with that one.
Sid, I love this this real gunslinger look you got going with your guitar. You don't need a stand, just throw it on your back. Pretty cool. Once again, if you're just joining us, I'm going to take a minute to introduce this Red Hot band. We've got Miss Dayna Lyn on my guitar and vocal duties. We got Miss Sydney Zadrovic, also on guitar and vocal duties. We have Mr. Keith Crockett himself on the bass and vocal duties as well. I'm Tyler Allen. Together we are the Red Hot Hayseeds. So I started this band mostly to play old swing tunes, and I really love Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, as you can probably imagine. Again, another band, or if you aren't aware, definitely go check out Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys. Gonna do one of their songs. This song is about a kid who just loves to eat. Can't get enough of it. All right. One, two, three, four. First words got away from me on that one a little bit.
A little tongue tied.
Yeah. Just
tongue on the post tied.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Sometimes when you get tied up, you just gotta sing gibberish and hope that you get it on the next one. All right. We're going to excuse Dayna here for a brief second, unless she just wants to awkwardly stand up here, but it's totally up to you, Day.
Yes.
This is an old instrumental tune. This is a song by Fats Waller. This song is called The Louisiana Fairy Tale.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, thank you folks very much. Dave's just returned from her pottery making class.
It was great. Highly recommend.
Alright. I'm going to play you another song of mine that will also be on our forthcoming album. When is it coming? I don't know. But it will be coming out this year. Fourth, yeah. Thank you to Sydney's mom. Thank you, Michelle. This is a little tune of mine called Honky Tonk Heart. With your honky tonk heart and my freewheeling mind, there's a long list of troubles that we're sure to find. You'll be reckless with me, I'll be careless with you. Together we'll make up a new shade of blue. Gone are the days when I just knew your stare. Your long golden locks had me trapped in a snare. What's on your mind, dear? It's too hard to tell. You say you won't, but your eyes say you will. With your own honky-tonk heart and my freewheeling mind, there's a long list of troubles that we're sure to find. You'll be reckless with me, I'll be careless with you. Together we'll make up a new shade of a little outside of our usual, a little outside of our realm of covers, I would say, a little beyond our era.
Yeah, but we started singing it the other night and just decided to do it today, so fun.
It's Emmylou Harris and Grant Parsons' tune. This is a little tune called Ooh Las Vegas, or Oh Las Vegas, however you want to read
it. Or Oops, Las Vegas.
right, kids. You ready?
Best of us. Like I said, we only sang this the other night.
Folks.
Four more hours.
Sweet. Perfect.
Oh, wow.
Cool.
Thank you. So at the start of the P word, Tyler and I were doing lots of live streams. So we love them. We're natural at them. But we never had a setup like this. What a treat. And we used to use a clap track after every song we sang so that we had a studio audience. It really helped. So thank you to our live in-studio audience that we actually have. It's really nice.
Got a couple more for you. Thank you so much. Once again to the Tongue on Post, all the crew here doing a bang up John on sound and video. It's another old song from a long time back. This is a set staple for us. We usually play as it's like a seven-piece band with another female singer, a clarinet player, fiddle, and drums usually is our MO. But we figured we kind of had to pare it down for this a little bit when Robert asked us. He said, "How big is your band?" I said, 5 to 8 people. And he said, "Well, I'm not sure if that worked." And I was like, "Well, I guess we can be 4. I guess. Bare minimum.
kilns aren't that big, is what we're trying to say.
This is a really big kiln.
Yeah.
Not
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Today we are the Red Hot Clay Seeds.
Ah, there you go. You found your pun.
Thank you.
Do you think? Were you thinking about that this entire time?
No.
Sure, sure. All right, this song is called I Want to Be a Cowboy's Sweetheart. Sydney, are you going to lead this one off? I think you are.
I am.
All right. One, two, one, two.
Your love, be your love.
So much, folks.
I'm into this camera. I feel like it's better.
You've never heard of Yodel Live? Oh, that's awesome. Well, you're welcome. Thanks to Sydney.
Oh. It's my party trick.
Well, it's a pretty good one. It's a lot more family-friendly than my party trick. Just kidding, I don't have any party tricks. All right, kids. Oh, we got one more tune for you. It's a bit of a long one here. Oh, wow, quite a few years ago now, I put out the word to Facebook asking all my musician friends, what are the best pieces of unsolicited advice you've ever been given? Because when you play music in bars, especially bars, people often like to make outlandish requests of you. And most of the time, it's super funny and we totally love it. No, it's not the case. Anyway, I asked my musician friends, what are the best things they've been told or had asked of them while they were on stage? And I ended up getting about 200 comments of just pure gold, pure cringy gold. So I took my own personal favorites and my favorites of my musician friends, and I put it to music. This song is called Play One We Know. Remember, these are all things real people have said to real musicians in real life. This is a bit of a warning.
Don't
disclaimer.
Do this.
Don't be this person.
Don't be this person.
Actually, no, I guess be this person so I can keep writing verses to this. But yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. This song is called Play When We Know. We've been the Red Hot Hayseeds. You've been wonderful. Thank you for all the folks watching in TV land. Once again, thank you to Midalta, Tongue on the Post Fest, Miss Snap Folk Club, and to Greg Carroll. Give it up for Greg Carroll. You can't see him right now, but it's fabulous. Thank you so much. This song's called Play When We Know. Take it away, Sydney. My wife can sing. You should let her get up there. Don't you know it's her birthday? And it's my birthday too, yeah. You could use a drummer, another guitar strummer. My friend can shred, he'll melt your face, and he needs a band. Do you know that one song? Everyone plays it. It's the one that goes, hey, mama, rock me. So play one we know. Play something we can dance to. Something with a good beat. I wanna shake my ass. I know we didn't pay for this. We still wanna hear this. Play them too fast, play them too loud, or just play one we know. Do you know any duets? How about Amazing Grace? I used to be a church girl. Just put the chords in your phone. That was my own personal favorite. I kinda like some of your songs. You know any sing-alongs. Why don't you change it up? 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 Little darling. Play one we know. Play something we can dance to. Something with a good beat. I wanna shake my ass. No, we didn't pay for this. We still wanna hear this. Play 'em too fast. Play 'em too loud, or just play one we know. Play something greasy, like Kid Rock or maybe AC/DC. What about Zeppelin, Slayer, John Mayer, Greg Carroll, Buddy Farrell, Zeppelin, Floyd Boy,
play one we know. Play something we can dance to. Something with a good beat. I wanna shake my ass. I know you didn't pay for this, but we still wanna hear the hits. Play 'em too fast, play 'em too loud, or just play one we know. Play 'em too fast, play 'em too loud, just.
Buddy, my whole family's here from Red Cliff, and we just want to hear some Skinnerd or some Sugar Ray or some Third Eye Blind. Just play one we know. Thank you so much, folks. We have the Red Hot Hayseeds. Hope to see you soon.
Gonna pop on stage here, see if we can fit five people up here.
We sure can.
What you should have done, not unsolicited advice, in between wide shots, just like sneak another band member in.
Yeah.
What the? Oh, there's six of them now. Red Hot Hayseeds, everybody. Round of applause for the local in-studio audience here. Do you mind if I ask a couple questions here before we wrap up for the day?
Away.
No, that's okay. It's all good. I was going to wear my coonskin hat today, but decided to leave it at home.
Well,
would have been embarrassing, don't you think?
Embarrassing.
Yeah. Red Hot Hayseeds, how long have you guys been a band?
Since 1923.
Yeah. I started this band probably like 5 years ago, but I would say current lineup has been the last 2 years, roughly. Yeah, mm-hmm. Give or take. I used to just do this band as a trio with other players, but then since have built it into kind of a much bigger
It kind of thing. Blossomed at the start of the P word because we were stuck at home learning all these songs together, and then
we just brought in a bunch of ringers.
Is it easy to find people who, you know, can really vibe with the old Western swing sound? Is it hard to find people, easy to find people?
It's certainly difficult. it's hard to find people who have a vested interest in playing this sort of style of music, for sure. But I feel like I've found all the people that I want to do it with, for sure.
And you were here last year as a solo artist. You're here this year with the band. How do the two experiences compare?
Oh, I don't really like playing solo very much anymore. It was fun. It was really fun to do it last year, don't get me wrong. But I really prefer playing with a band and just having a fuller sound and different instrumentation.
Now, when it comes to writing songs in the band, is it very much a collaborative effort, or...?
I've written the songs, pretty much all of the songs so far, and then we've worked together to arrange some of them, and then we did one of Keith's songs that he just kind of wrote on his own, but we all kind of did a little bit of arranging with it, and yeah, so it's a bit of both, I would say. Hey!
And you mentioned that you've got the forthcoming album, not sure on that release date just yet, but what do you hope to accomplish in the near future?
Well, we'd really, whenever it's okay, we'd sure like to play across Canada. We've mostly just stuck to Western Canada so far. Really love to make it over to Europe, as there is a pretty huge appreciation for Western swing and old-time country over there, so yeah.
Also, cheese, they have so much.
Oh, so much good cheese, yeah.
Unbelievable.
The future is, our sights are set on cheese, mostly.
Cheese in the future.
Yeah.
Okay, and we're thank you so much for stopping by at the Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival. Before we wrap up, is there anything else you guys would like to mention, anything like that? How can we keep an eye on you guys?
On all your various forms of social media, we stay pretty active on there. I'd like to say hi to Pete and Nina, and the Hintz family. Love you guys. And shout out to Rob at home. I'm sorry you can't be here, buddy. I hope you feel better soon, but Your wife and company has taken real good care of us, so thanks for having us. And yeah, thank you so much, Logan.
Thank you so much for stopping by the Red Hot Hayseeds and Greg Carroll. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in for day three of the Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival. We'll be back with day four tomorrow. And again, you can support the Medicine Hat Folk Music Club and the artist you've been seeing all week with paywhatyoucan.mhfolkmusic.com. Day four tomorrow. We hope to see you right here. And have a good afternoon, good night, good morning. Until then, take care.